This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for atazanavir and variation in the gene UGT1A1. This guideline was last updated in September 2015. Due to the risk of bilirubin-related discontinuation of atazanavir in patients who are UGT1A1 poor metabolizers, it is recommended to consider an alternative agent in these patients, particularly where jaundice would be of concern. In patients who are UGT1A1 intermediate or extensive metabolizers, there is no need to avoid prescribing atazanavir based on the UGT1A1 genetic test result. This image is adapted from the PharmGKB Atazanavir Pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below the video. Atazanavir is used to treat HIV infection. It is known to inhibit the protein UGT1A1. UGT1A1 is responsible for the glucuronidation of hundreds of compounds. This glucuronidation makes compounds water-soluble, allowing for their biliary or renal elimination. One of the compounds that UGT1A1 glucuronidates is bilirubin. If UGT1A1 has reduced function, bilirubin can build up in the blood and tissues and cause jaundice. Individuals with jaundice may prematurely discontinue atazanavir. The most frequent genetic variant affecting UGT1A1 function is a dinucleotide TA repeat polymorphism known as RS8175347. The number of TA repeats can vary from 5 to 8. 6 TA repeats is designated as the reference allele, or UGT1A1*1. In all populations studied to date, 6 TA repeats and 7 TA repeats, known as UGT1A1*28, occur the most frequently. 5 TA repeats, known as UGT1A1*36, and 8 TA repeats, known as UGT1A1*37, are infrequent or absent depending on geographic region or ancestry. Both UGT1A1*28 and UGT1A1*37 cause a reduction in gene transcription and decreased protein function as compared to UGT1A1*1, while UGT1A1*36 appears to cause higher transcription levels and increased protein function as compared to UGT1A1*1. The RS88782C:T polymorphism, also known as UGT1A1*80, has also been found to be associated with bilirubin concentrations. The RS887829T allele is in very strong linkage disequilibrium with UGT1A1*28 and UGT1A1*37 alleles, while the C allele is in very strong linkage disequilibrium with the UGT1A1*1 and UGT1A1*36 alleles. The RS414-8323-G:A polymorphism, also known as UGT1A1*6, is also an independent predictor of bilirubin concentrations and is associated with reduced UGT1A1 function. This variant is found almost exclusively among individuals of East Asian ancestry. UGT1A1 diplotypes can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the information in this table can be found in Table 1 of the guideline. A link to the guideline is provided in the description below this video. This table includes a selection of example diplotypes, a table showing the association between UGT1A1 diplotypes and likely phenotypes for commonly tested UGT1A1 alleles can be found on the PharmGKB website. A link to this table is provided in the description below this video. Additionally, a full list of known UGT1A1 alleles and function can be found at the UGT Official Nomenclature website. A link to this website is provided in the description below this video. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for atazanavir. Patients who are extensive metabolizers have a low likelihood for bilirubin-related discontinuation, and therefore there is no need to avoid prescribing atazanavir based on the UGT1A1 genetic test result in these patients. The classification of this recommendation is strong. Patients who are intermediate metabolizers have a low likelihood of bilirubin-related discontinuation, and therefore there is no need to avoid prescribing atazanavir based on the UGT1A1 genetic test result in these patients. The classification of this recommendation is strong. Patients who are poor metabolizers have a high likelihood of bilirubin-related discontinuation. In these patients, an alternative agent should be considered, particularly where jaundice would be of concern to the patient. The classification of this recommendation is strong. All of these dosing recommendations can be found in Table 2 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. A link to the guideline is provided in the description below this video. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the combination of alleles, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific diplotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guidelines or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.